Hey guys, Blaze here with Moves Media, and today I'm going to be showing you how to create 360 videos. Step one, the camera. So before you start shooting 360, you need a camera. Now there are two main types of cameras. The first being a single camera setup. This is one camera, takes 360 video and photos. All you need to do is clack the one button and bam, you've got your 360 photo or video ready to go. Second option is your multi-camera setup. Now this has multiple cameras, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and what you do is you record simultaneously and then in post-production stitch all that footage together into one seamless 360 video or photo sphere. A lot more work, but this has a lot better quality, a lot cheaper, and a lot simpler to use.
Now there are a lot of different 360 degree cameras out there. I recommend two if you're going for a single camera setup, and that's the Ricoh Theta and Samsung Gear 360. I've tested both these cameras and they produce really good results for the price point that they're at.
If you're going to one of these guys, simple to use, affordable, you know, obviously pretty good quality, then stop watching this video now because you're ready to go. Stop watching, turn it off. And if you're interested in creating some better quality stuff and using a multi-camera rig, then I'm gonna show you the steps in order to do that. First thing is, for as far as which cameras to buy, the more cameras you have in this sphere, the better quality your video is gonna be, but the more work that's gonna be involved in putting it all together. Now, I'm gonna fast track you, and instead of getting into the details of it, just go get a six camera setup. The next thing is, now that you've got your six camera setup, this isn't a six camera setup, but don't worry about that. You're gonna need to sync all your cameras together using the GoPro remote. Now this one right here is what you need to sync into all your cameras. So once all these cameras are linked to one remote, then you're gonna basically use the remote to start your recording with the magical record button. There's the most important step perhaps in 360 filmmaking, and that is syncing your cameras. Now, rigs that are like this one, that are just a shell, you can see there's no camera there, it's just a shell that you can put your cameras into, or there's the GoPro Omni, which does the syncing for you. Now, the GoPro Omni, a bit more expensive. Personally, I've had great success with something cheaper like this, and works great. All you gotta do is the important sync step. There's two types of sync. There's the audio sync, which it's very technical. You ready? Boom. One loud clap, cameras are all audio synced. Second one is the motion sync, and that just requires you to either spin your cameras or shake them a little bit like this, and then what that's gonna do is when you're using your post-production software, it's gonna register that shake or that clap, and that's gonna sync the cameras all perfectly. Now you may be wondering, hey, you started them all the exact same time with this remote, but guess what? This remote doesn't start them all the exact same time. It's almost the exact same time, but if your cameras are a fraction of a second off, then you're gonna really notice if any movement goes between your cameras. So make sure you do that sync step, it's really important. Also highly recommend using the audio sync, because I find it's much more accurate than the shake sync. But important to do both, because we've been out in high winds or lots of background noise, and some of the cameras won't hear your clap, and then you don't have a sync if you didn't do the backup with the shake. Okay, now you've captured your scene on your multiple camera setup, and now you have to take it from camera to computer. And what you're gonna need is some video editing and stitching software. The first thing you need is the stitching software, and without going into which one's the best one, I'm gonna tell you right now, you need to get Color's Autopano Video Pro and Autopano Giga. They work, two different programs that work together, it's really intuitive, great program. Go ahead, go grab that. I'll put the link in the video description. So now I don't want to miss the important step of how we get the footage from the cameras to the computer, because as a beginner, this is going to save you a lot of time if you just take a few extra seconds to really make sure that you're organizing your footage properly. So what's going to happen is you're going to eject your memory cards like this, boom, micro SD, put it into your computer, and label each file with the camera number and the shot number. So the first shot you took of the day is gonna be C1, one, which means camera one, shot one. make sure you take that extra second, because it's going to save you a whirlwind of time later and a lot of frustration and headaches.
Okay, so we're going to open up our editing software and the file that we've stored our footage. We have should have six camera files all labeled properly, and we're going to actually drag them across into Autopano Video Pro and drop them in. Now you're going to see them up in the top timeline there. Should be six files all in the top. And the first step we got to do to stitch is go to the synchro button in the top of the bar and open that up. And we're going to see that there's some options here. Now what we'll do is we'll actually select the place in our timeline. That's where the blue area is here, where we actually made that synchronization. And we're going to just select a 10-second window between backly forward and back of the video timeline where it's going to register to where that sync happened. We're going to click on the synchronize by audio, and we're going to get accurate synchronization found, and we'll just apply that to all the clips by hitting apply, and we have all our videos perfectly aligned and synchronized based off of that clap. Now next step we want to do is go to our stitch icon. Make sure the first one says GoPro HERO 3 Plus or 4 and current selection. Then we're going to hit stitch. And after the bottom bar gets to full, we should get one nice, clean 360 degree stitch. There we go. We've got our 360 degree footage all stitched into one. Looks pretty good, although I don't know if you can tell, but it's upside down and a bit distorted, so we can fix that no problem. We're gonna just drag the footage down like this and just get a basic look and feel so you can tell that it is in fact a good 360 stitch, and we'll apply that just like that. Our first step we're going to do is click the color button to make sure that the different cameras have different colorations because they're shot at different orientations to the sun. So we're going to align them to look all the same. So we're going to check our three exposure, color, and vignetting boxes and hit apply, and then we're going to get one nice kind of seamless color, and we can adjust the color line to make it darker and lighter depending on where we want it to get a good alignment between our lights and our darks. So that looks pretty good. I'm pretty happy with that. What we can do now is actually hit the edit button, and what that's going to do is open the other program that we work in tandem with. That's Autopano Giga, which is for your refined stitching and editing your stitch lines and your control points. Now, I'm going to go over this quite quickly because I can do an in-depth analysis later, but this is just going to give you the basics. First thing I do when I open this up is hit these vertical lines, which are going to make your footage aligned properly and get us a good horizon. So you just drag them onto the flat points that are in your footage, walls, poles, trees, or you can use your horizon like back there. And we'll just put a few of these up and then hit the check icon, and you'll see the footage gets aligned and the horizon's much nicer in the background. So next thing I'll do is I'm going to check my control points. I can see there are some places here that don't have a perfect stitch, and there are some kind of glitchy looking zones. So what you can do to fix those is, well, you can first click on this little marker to see where your different cameras, what areas they're using. Then you go into your stitch, your control points, which are these here. This is two cameras, one basically that are stitched together, and you can see those green dots. Those are actually where the software has registered are the same points in both the footage. Now you can just select both sides like this to try and get the camera to send some more points. Now orange means it's not a great control point. It's not 100% accurate. Green means it's really good. So you can try and do it a few more times, trial and error, zoom in. Sometimes you need to add manual control points, but again, I won't get too into this because there's a lot of work involved in getting a perfect stitch for some points that don't want to align initially using the software. So once you've done that, you've got a pretty good stitch, and this is basically you're ready to export and turn it into a 360 video. So you can close Autopano Giga and go back to Autopano Video Pro, and you're going to basically just export this footage in a 360 format. On your timeline, you can use the red bar to actually select the region you want to export. So I'm going to reduce this so I don't have to export the entire clip because I only need a small chunk of it. I'm going to click the render button, select the format you want to export your footage in, create the file name. I'm just going to name this pool scene and hit save there, and then just hit the render button, and that'll start rendering in the top left panel there. You can actually work on a different segment while that's rendering in the background, or you can just let it roll. So once that's done, I'm going to show you guys what the footage looks like and how to open it. Okay, so my rendering's done, and what I'm gonna do is just find where I exported it to. So there's my video clip, and I'm gonna open that in GoPro 360 VR viewer. So all I gotta do is open my GoPro VR player and drag my stitched scene into the player. And now you can see I have my 360 video, and all I'm doing is clicking and dragging to move the sphere around and look all around the footage. You can see the stitch is pretty good. There are some definite glitch zones. There's the tripod below, which you can actually edit out in post-production, but I can go into that in a different video. Otherwise, really cool to have this 360 degree video completed. You can look all around, see where we are in the pool. You can zoom in a bit or do some crazy formats, but that gives you a sense of what it looks like once you're done with it.
Okay guys, that concludes this tutorial on how to make a 360 video. Hope it was really helpful for you. If you have any questions, write them down in the comment section below and I'll get back to you and help you guys out. I was there where you were, where I hadn't created a thing, and I know that it can be challenging, but stick with it. If you like this video, please like it, subscribe to it, and share it with your friends. Thanks very much guys, thanks for watching.